What's up? Let's see, we'll give everybody a second to roll in. Test 1, 2. All right, just checking to make sure everything okay. I got my phone over here. All right. Appreciate it, big guy. What's going on, everybody? How you doing? Happy Wednesday. Happy 2023. Yeah, I figured I'm probably going to make this a weekly thing. We're going to start doing some different stuff. We're going to work on some music. We're going to work on some track breakdowns, answer any questions you guys may have, and possibly do some live mixes and get into a ton of fun stuff. So this is kind of still like test number two, but a little bit more official. Just dropped a new record last Friday, and yeah, so maybe we'll break that down today. I see you guys all in here. What's up? What's up, everybody? Rain, what's going on? How you doing? Oh, and Big Guy, I appreciate you making that Discord. Appreciate it. So yeah, I guess like for right now, as all you guys are coming in, we'll maybe answer some questions or see what you guys are saying, because this is once again like really cool, and I'm gonna be making a big effort to stay consistent with you guys and make sure that ultimately you guys have a place to come to and have some fun. So I don't know, what are you guys feeling? Like, is there anything in particular in the future streams that you guys may want to see? How did I make the lead chords in my XO remix? Well, we could go into all that stuff. I pretty much use fairly the same process, but yeah, I'll break down. I think today I'm gonna break down the Culture Code record, the Culture Code collaboration that I did, Spaces on the Wall, and we could just like play it, go through, and if there's anything that jumps out at you, we could kind of break that stuff down. I'd love to do a breakdown of Enough. That'd be really cool. Why am I so nice? It could be a cold world, man. You gotta make sure you put a smile on and try to make people happy, I guess. Plus I have two kids, so being able to chill with you guys is a lot of fun. What are the plans for the future? I mean, I think the plans for the future, possibly an EP, maybe a single or two. Before that, I mean, I'm sitting on a body of work right now that I definitely am eager to finish up and get out there. So yeah, I would say that's the first thing. Second thing is to make sure I'm interacting with you guys on a weekly basis, you know? I think the most important thing, especially nowadays, is to be able to find ways to engage with your supporters and somehow find a way to give back. Like, obviously, I'd love to be touring, which would be number three. But in the meantime, I think it's just super cool to have you guys in here, being able to chat with you. And yeah. So as far as my plans, that's it as of right now, you know, just dropping music and chilling with you guys. Peter, do you use own samples? So, and Rain, by the way, thank you for the comment, man. Thank you. I appreciate you. So yeah, I'll run through it and I'll kind of show you ways. Like, I like to resample my own stuff, and I really do enjoy almost like making tracks and resampling them or taking vocals, doing all weird sorts of stuff with it, and then basically bringing it into the track and then possibly resampling it again and just morphing it and morphing it and morphing it until you get something cool. Big guy, how do you do the vocal leads from stuff like Back to You? The vocal lead, believe it or not, for Back to You is me. It's just like chipmunked out. I think I recorded it pretty slow. And then I recorded it slow, like tempo-wise. And then I sped the tempo up, pitched my vocal up, and it gave it this weird little chipmunky sound. How do you make the drop synths from Send Me Your Love remix? That one is, I think that one's kind of old. So that was just a bunch of massive presets that I made at the time and just kind of joined them all up together. I mean, back in the day, it was pretty crazy when you were making dubstep, because you would have to find a way to make a bunch of sounds make sense. And that's always the hardest part with music, because a lot of the times what you're hearing could be a bunch of noise, but then all of a sudden it makes sense and you're like, oh, this is it. So with the Send Me Your Love remix, that's pretty much what happened. I have toured in the past, like never officially toured, but yeah, I think with the body of work that I'm working on right now, touring, like I'd be able to have more of a vibe in a show, and I'm sure you guys will hear it and hopefully understand like where I'm going with it. How do dubstep collabs work? To be honest, they could work a million different ways. You can be in the room with somebody, you could send stems, you could do ideas over the internet. I mean, nowadays it's virtually endless with how you can collaborate. And of course, I would love to collab with the god himself, Skrillex. That'd be huge. Let's see. Yeah, Luke, that'd be awesome, man. I definitely want to work on some music live for sure. How does it feel to be the most creative melodic dubstep producers? Ah, well, I really appreciate the comment. And yeah, I don't know what to say. I try to have fun. I try to keep things interesting. As you know, the years go on, you learn all these new things, but at the same time, your creativity can morph. So I think the more you think like a kid and you keep yourself interested in what you're doing, that's how you stay creative at the end of the day. Peter, any advice for new DJs and producers? Peter, I think like now in 2023, there are a million ways to get started, to improve, to learn. Like the list goes on and on. Like you could sign up for Patreons. You could go on YouTube, research like how a certain sound is made. I mean, there's just so much information that's out there that if you're just able to access it and find it and just go on these YouTube rabbit holes, I promise you, you'll find it, because that's ultimately how I learned. And by the way, too, I'm thinking of possibly in the future, and you guys let me know of potentially doing some sort of, you know, one-on-one class where basically there's these new, this new plugin. I don't know how new it is or old it is. It's called Muse, but I could basically, if you're like working in Ableton, ideally, I can basically work on your session from my computer and we could face chat. So something to think about. I don't know. Lost Pages, how do you handle the new era of music? Because dubstep kind of is a part of the past. It still has an impact, but it obviously has changed a lot. Do you think the adaptation was a good or bad thing? Honestly, I think the way electronic music evolved changed music forever. I mean, in every single genre, from country to hip hop to pop, like all over, you have touches of electronic dance music. And as far as like the dubstep scene itself, I think it kind of evolved where you have this like super cult following that just, it evolved into this really hard thing. Like that kind of dubstep, the harder dubstep that's going on right now, like Subtronics and stuff like that, that kind of sound was big in Colorado. Like I lived in Colorado for a little bit, and you know, you'd go to like Cervantes or wherever, and you would hear that kind of stuff. And I think it is so sick that it kind of evolved almost back to its roots in 2023. But also the other side of dubstep, which is kind of like the route that I took, is there were all of these different techniques and ways of making and creating sounds where ultimately you were able to, or at least I was and other producers, you're able to take those techniques and apply it into like a morphed version of dubstep. Like, it's funny because I don't even know what I'm making anymore because I've morphed things over and over and over again. But yeah, it's crazy. It's hard to put a title on genres in this day and age. Alessio, appreciate you. Awesome. Since middle school, that's great. Oh, just hit my head on the mic. Hold on. I'm just trying to, I have the comments on my phone, by the way. I got to get a secondary screen. So next time I won't be looking like this way, but my phone is literally right here and I'm reading the comments off of there. So excuse me. Do I ever look back at old songs and go like, this is epic, or damn, I made this crap? Absolutely. 100%. To be honest, whenever I make a song and release it, it's happening a lot less nowadays. But normally, like the first month, I can't even listen to my own track because I've put so much into it. And I just need to step away because there's this one quote where it's like a song is never finished, it's abandoned. So that's kind of what happens with me. I just abandon that thing and I just run as far away from it as I possibly can. Session 13, how is my workflow? So I have a template set up in Ableton. I could even show you guys that after we get done with some questions. So it could start a bunch of different ways. Like it could sometimes happen where I'm just fiddling around on the piano and then I like record some stuff, vocals, and then I start resampling, throw it in sampler. Like I could show you a couple cool ways that I could pretty much guarantee, for at least for myself, that will keep me inspired. It's kind of like a foolproof way. It's like you get this wide variety of sounds. I'll show you that. If you stick with it, I'll show you that shortly after I break down the track. What do I think of Illenium? I think Illenium is incredible. I actually have met him once or twice, and he has been grinding his butt off for so long. I mean, I can't even tell you how hard this dude has grinded. I mean, he has put in so much work over these years, so he absolutely deserves all the success. Super talent. One of my favorite songs with John Bellion. You know, super talented guy. And yeah, wish him nothing but the best. Yeah, funk does seem like the modern day dubstep in a way. I noticed that on like stream, game streamers, they play a lot of that stuff. And I think it's dope. I'd love to actually mess around with that one day. Big guy. Is it like the way that when you record yourself saying it's like, that is what it's like for me, even whenever it says I can sing. You know what, big guy? Like, I've been doing it long enough at this point. Like, I've been singing for as long as I can remember. I think I've just gotten used to it at this point. I think when you're getting into singing, it's kind of like, to be honest, I'm so used to myself singing that when I hear myself talking, I almost kind of cringe a little bit. So, like, I'm so used to myself singing that it doesn't even faze me at this point. You love when I call him big guy. Luke, I've never really tried sampling stuff over and over like that. Sounds like a cool technique to make unique sounds. Yeah, 100%. I mean, there are an infinite amount of ways to, whatchamacallit, there's an infinite amount of ways to resample and do things. Like, the amount of plugins that are coming out, obviously, you can use those things, and those are great. But also, just like stock Ableton stuff. I don't know, Luke, what program are you using? I'd love to know. Floating Boy, what's up? What's up? All right, cool. Well, listen. Oh, you use Logic. Okay. All right, sweet. Stock Ableton is amazing. Would I ever start doing more modern stuff? Yeah, of course. Absolutely. Absolutely. Listen, I am not tied to any genre whatsoever. Not whatsoever. So I am open to do anything if it sounds cool and it's fun. If you could choose, where would you live, or is the current country fire? Well, obviously, or is the current country fine? Sorry. I love it here, obviously, but recently on TikTok, I have been seeing, what is it? What was the place called? Oh, I'm drawing a blank now. There's a certain place, and I can't remember the name. I'm sorry. If I remember, if it comes to me, I'll say it, but that place. It's like these TikTok videos that show up. And by the way, my TikTok is K Drew Music. Just I think someone had asked about that before. But yeah, it's on there. I get these videos all the time, and I'm like, yes, I would love to live there. Oxford, you are not annoying by no means, Session 13. What is my opinion on hyperpop? So, all right. My cousin, believe it or not, like he works on music, awesome producer. And I think, I'm pretty sure he was getting or is into hyperpop. And I think the last Skrillex record with 100 Gex, Torture Me, I think that was kind of like a combination of bit of dubstep, but the vocals are hyperpop, right? Like, am I getting that wrong? Because I keep hearing the word, and I'm pretty sure it's like, I can't really explain the vibe, but like, you just, when you hear it, you know it's hyperpop. Okay. Yeah, it's definitely a mix, for sure, for sure. All right, cool. Well, let's, for all my people that are producers in here, like, I want to see what you guys think of, I want to see what kind of questions you guys may have, looking at this stuff. Miss Murphy, see you later. Have a great day of work. All right, cool. So look, I'm going to try to keep up with chat at the same time, because I'm going to jump into Ableton, and please adjust your eyes, because there might be a lot of tracks. All right, so I'm just making sure that my key commands work. There we go. Boom. All right. Also, too, I'm definitely going to have to fix my camera. But this is ultimately what a session for me looks like. Lot of tracks, but it could be a little intimidating because there's a lot of little bits and pieces that go into this. So right out the gate here, let's see if we do this, if that works. Alrighty. So from the beginning, this is, by the way, the Spaces on the Wall, the collaboration I did with my brothers, Culture Code. Let's see, we're making sure we get some sound. Oh, sorry. Got to change my audio output. Let me just make sure we're getting audio to come out. I'm checking it on my phone as we speak. Hold on, sorry. There we go. Cool. Alrighty. Cool. So we're going to just kind of listen through. Maybe, I don't know how many of you guys heard it. Maybe we'll listen through just till the end of the first drop, and then we'll kind of break it down, all right? Love you, Lost Pages. Appreciate you. A little breath of wind can feel like. Appreciate you, Nezra. Sometimes I turn my back to you in my sleep, and I know it hurts you, but I get hurt too. I don't know if I can hold on. Loving is a heart lock, and I'm running out. How you guys feeling this track, by the way? Would love to know. Appreciate you guys. All right. So there's the first half. I'm seeing who's the vocals on there. It is not me. It is not Culture Code. It is actually this wonderful, talented person that goes by the name of Julia Church. So you should definitely check her out. She is incredible. Absolutely incredible. All right, cool. So let's break this down a little bit. We have the intro, which is pretty sweet, that Culture Code did for me. So we got all these little stems here. They did all these cool little tweaks, little glitches and whatnot. Drums. Thank you, Luken. So then that goes into this little section here, which is the verse section. And it's pretty simple. We have her vocal here. I'll mute that for a second. Everything underneath this is super, super, super simple. Super simple. And a lot of it, going back to what I said before, a lot of it is like resampling and tweaking. Like this is just some weird little morph thing that I made that I ended up freezing from Labs. This is some little guitar thing from Contact. Yo, it's the Bullseye guy. What's good? So then a lot of the times too, what I'll do is I'll take the vocal, and there's this application that's like, I don't even know if it's a real thing anymore. Like, you can't buy it. But basically, you could take vocals and stretch them out. So anytime I'm working on a track, I will take a vocal, and I'll show you guys here. So this is basically just the a cappella completely stretched out. All right, I'm actually going to use my mouse. Okay. So check this out. So it just hyper extends everything, okay? Super ambient. You just get all of these amazing textures and whatnot. So I will constantly do that in my productions. And I will just spread them across the track for like little bits of ear candy. It's like you have this one here. That's just sitting low in the background. Very low. Then you also have this little... Oh, where'd it go? Then you got this here. This is literally just some super drawn out, reverbed out thing with a little bit of auto pan. Of course you gotta have the bass. So where's our bass? Bass is doing a bunch of, I have a couple little groups. I have a couple little of things going on. So one of these is just printed. I think this is just a sub or kind of like a little Reese thing. Hey, sounds like Paul Stretch. You nailed it. You absolutely nailed it. I saw Paul Stretch in the chat. And I'm like, wow. So yeah, we got some Reese's here. And then this one, I resampled it back in. And got all these weird little extra automations with some formant. Drums. Everything super simple. Super simple. Here's the drums. Super, super simple. Easy. Then we got our build up here. Can I show the drums? Of course. Of course. Yeah, if I'm moving a little quick, these are just some basic little loops, man. Like just some little things. Of course, like I'll go in and I'll like play around with them a little bit, but sometimes like you just need the smallest little thing. Smallest little thing. Basic kick and snare. In a drum group. Super easy. Oh, Rage Dasher. Good luck. Seriously, don't be nervous. It's all good. You got this. I mean, speaking in front of people could be a little bit nerve-wracking, but 100% you got this, okay? You got it. And make sure you come back. Like, whether you hit me up on Instagram or on TikTok or whatever, hit me up. Let me know you killed it, because I know you will. What is that snare? All right, so this snare is a cymatic snare, but with a ton of processing on it, okay? It's literally just a rim shot, but we got a few things going on here. So I'll break these out for you guys so you could see. So this is the snare dry, just, pretty basic. Added a bit of spiff on it. Spiff, for any of you guys that don't know, spiff is basically a transient designer. So it allows you to isolate frequencies and boost them. Kind of like an EQ, but instead it's just using a transient. Very simple. All right. So there's that. We got a shaper box to add a little bit of noise to that. So shaper box is cool. It's got all these sweet little tools and whatnot, so that you're able to either shape, you could, it speaks for itself, you could shape your sound. Statifix, appreciate you. Appreciate you. All right. There's that, and then there's some saturation here. Saturation is just to kind of clip what's going on after the noise is being added to it. You could kind of see around here. And then I'm just running a parallel with full reverb on it. Also, too, I got some automation here. The automation's there just for, I think, yeah, some spots in the drop, just because I don't want the reverb anymore. In Ableton, this is like a really useful tool to be able to go in and basically just duplicate the track, add an effect to it, but completely wet. So that way you can automate the volume, but you're not like losing, you're not losing any of like the wetness, if that makes sense. But yeah, so that's the snare. I mean, we can go as deep as we want over drums, because that's always a fun thing to get into. All right, cool. So here we go. Dreco, appreciate you. Hopefully I said that right. Sorry, I'm like reading the chat and I'm like saying the word that I'm reading, even though it's not what I meant to say. All right, the audio effect rack and intro rack also help with efficiency. Absolutely. Do I layer the drum during the drop? Well, why don't we get to the drop? Right here. Here we go. I will solo it too. Cool. So this kind of goes into the whole idea of using what you have, like trying, like sometimes if you are working on a remix, if you're working on the, you know, the beginning stages of your own track, a lot of the times the elements that you first introduce into the record can be absolutely vital to your creative process, and you could just use it in a different way. You know, a lot of the times in the past, I would just kind of go for a preset and, you know, next thing you know, you have this jumbled mess of sound and you're trying to make sense of it. Whereas if you're writing a song or you have a melody and you're playing piano and you're singing something over it and all of a sudden something sticks, 9 times out of 10, like that is the song. That is the thing that's making you want to continue to write the song. So with Julia, she had this awesome little melody line here. So I'm actually going to shut off the sidechain real quick. And basically this little thing, ooh, that thing is being teased the entire time, like everywhere, in the intro, in the drop, in the buildup, in the outro, like all over the place, because it is just that one thing that just made the most sense. You know what I mean? So this is it. Right? Super simple. Super, super simple. But for whatever reason, when I heard that one vocal, I was like, man, I could do a million things with this. But overall, just the melody itself was so infectious. So then ultimately what I did for the drop was I came in here and I had the whole group. And I took all the vocals. So I think the sidechain's off. Yep. Even the breaths too. So now, here's all this processing here. Let me actually delete these ones right here. Let me check this out. Cool. All right, so here's everything off right here. Sorry. There's like a couple different layers in there or whatever. But once we start adding the layers on the plugins on top of it, it starts to transform. And I kind of have my own little process. This is a huge one. Draco, I'm sure you know, this thing is huge. What I love about Little Altar Boy is you are able to morph stuff like crazy. So if you have a group of vocals like this, and then you do a Foreman shift and some drive, it just does something weird to it that you can't explain. Little Altar Boy is the truth. So basically, it's like taking everything from the left and right speaker, or left and right headphone, rather, and it's like distorting it, because that's like the one thing with Little Altar Boy is you'll get these weird little stereo artifacts. So it's kind of like crunching everything on the sides, and it's making the middle information a little more formanty, but it's still kind of like hard to decipher what exactly is going on. Now, another thing, this is like another chain. So like, once again, I'm doing everything parallel. Peter, thanks for stopping in. Appreciate you. So here we got dry signal here. This guy, Ableton vocoder, stock. And that, I think I have a signal somewhere where it's just, it's basically like a sidechain signal. Or not a, yeah, I'm sidechaining the audio from vocoder. You can see right there. So yeah, there's that. Another little Altar Boy. And then this one is super cool. This one is one of the most fun. It's called Morph by Zynaptic. It's like the sister of Pitchmap, but it's kind of like a vocoder not on steroids, because it's very simple, but you could get some cool effects. So like, same thing, I'm getting the signal from the vocoder. So it's kind of got that like resonating vibe to it, if that makes sense. But then, yeah, all together. Oh, gotta turn the sidechain on. All right. Okay. Oh, yeah. Duh. That's why I'm like, why is that not loud? Because I forgot. Classic OTT. Little bit of EQ. Just brighten things up, cutting off the low end. Of course, Pro L. Need Pro L. Pro L2 is probably one of the best. One of the best. A little bit of Saturn, crisping it up. EQ, working on midsides. Another EQ, just to cut off some of the highs. Then Soothe, and a little bass clef, easy washout. So yeah, super, super simple. Pro L is a dub for sure. All right. So then here's like another cool thing that I love to do. And let's see what we got. All right. So pretty simple. Let me try to pull up these automations. Like, I am notorious for not making automation lanes. Can we see the vocoder signal? Yeah, the MIDI. Absolutely. Absolutely. Where is it? It always gets lost. Like, I swear, I'll make the vocoder signal, and then this is always the way I have to find it. So I go like this, and then I have to look. All right, so it's track 173. All right. So 173, where's 173? All right, cool. It's in the vocals. Vocoder, super simple. Wavetable, square wave. Like, this is it. Why can't we hear it? There we go. Because the rest of the track soloed. There we go. Or is this one soloed up here? There we go. There we go. Sorry. Why is that happening? Oh, because it was muted. Duh. Sorry. All right. Very simple. And by the way, if you have Wavetable, this setting right here, Shimmer, is awesome. Super cool. So yeah, that's the vocoder setting right there. Just a little like kind of triangle and Wavetable. Are those vocals layers just doubles? Yes. Yeah, they're just doubles as well as like a couple that are just kind of created in Melodyne. Yeah, Draco, Wavetable is slept on big time. I mean, you can literally in Wavetable make whatever you want. Absolutely whatever you want. I mean, I think it's even easier to use sometimes because you could route it much easier to other things because it's an Ableton plugin. So yeah, 100%. Let's see here. All right, cool. So these are the basses, the main bass. So this is an 808 that I made, just like a super long 808 that I processed. I don't know, this is always in my sessions. So I constantly use it. It's just, I found it's got like the coolest lower fundamental. Where if you have like below a C, like if you're at a B or something, I mean, an A is super low, but, I find that the harmonics are still relatively audible on headphones, but also on like laptop speakers or speakers at home. So I always kind of start with this, and this one, super easy, super simple. I just have a little bit of noise on top. And then nothing there. Don't know why that's there. Oh, that's muted. I was like, wow, did I just have two basses going and not know? Then I'm running it through Rift. I'm not doing much here. Just giving it a little bit of fuzz, a little bit of body. Then I'm taking a little bit more of the mid-range. I think this is even automated here. Yeah, for certain spots, I'm kind of like accentuating a frequency into the saturator, which comes next. And then there's auto pan for certain points like here. But overall, it's a fuzzy bass. This one's pretty cool. I love this one. This is where you're kind of getting like the like fake growls, but I'm still like, just to show you, I'm still using the same 808 sample that I used for like the sub bass. All I'm doing is just driving frequencies. I'm not even driving it into anything special. I mean, like literally look at this chain right here. Like this is nothing. It's like just a frequency running into a drive, but it's just being automated. So you're getting these cool little frequencies. You know? So yeah, like there's just a million ways you could get to an idea, but ultimately it's like how it fits underneath. So like we could sit and isolate all these different sounds, but ultimately when you play it all together, it's kind of how it is perceived together. You know what I mean? That makes any sense? All right, actually, so really quick, we will go over to here. And then what I think will be really cool is I forget who asked about like the inspiration side of how to like kind of stay inspired. I'll kind of give you a little demo to show you how I stay inspired, like by resampling and stuff like that. Like just weird little techniques, okay? But it'll be like one of a few that we could get into the other ones at a later time. So then there's this shop over here. So yeah, sorry, I don't have the sidechain on, so if it blew your ears out, I apologize. So actually, this sound right here, I needed to freeze for some reason. I think there was like an update with Ableton where for whatever reason, Wavetable was crashing. But this is literally, I think it's the same exact thing with like the shimmer on it. But with like an arpeggiator and like a lot of distortion. And just all this different like automation happening on this end. Where it's kind of going like here, it's just kind of, the width is going out. It's also going like left to right, you know? And then we got all of these cool little things happening here. Same thing. Same thing, that vocal tag, I'm telling you. That, and then where's, I think I got some like little wubs in here. Did I not even, hold on, let's see. Where's that happening? Okay. This, I froze. Not sure if I can get to the original, but yeah. Oh, this is because it was in Morph. Yeah. So just resampling, this one here is, I think I just took the sound here. I took one of these guys right here and I just dropped it down. How do I get such clean pitch bends? Well, you could get it with automation or the tape stop. Exactly, Dreco. Appreciate you being in here. Like, oh, I thought you were saying tape stop. Yeah, like literally tape stop for some of these things. I think tape stop is really cool. I like to use the kilohertz one. Wait, do I already have it on here? I might even have it on here already. No, I don't. So this is just super simple. You basically just like automate where you want it to shut off. And then you can play with the stop time. So yeah, that's how you could get some cool pitch bends or automation or other ways like that. Yeah, tape stop is pretty useful. So like in situations here, I think I already had it printed on there. Yeah. So it's already kind of doing that. And then you're getting like all of this extra growly, gargly from literally from, once again, stock Ableton. I just have it on modulator mode. So modulator mode is giving it this. Almost like disperser sounding thing. And then this is just being ran like a vocoder, you know? So this is a sound, just a serum patch, just super easy. And I'm just kind of taking the dry wet in and out a little bit. So you have like that moment, right? And basic chorus. Bringing out the stereo width a little bit. Yeah, but overall, like basic stuff. Very basic. Ooh, the drums on this one. The drums are cool. Because Culture Code, for this last drop, like Culture Code had this great idea of basically turning the last drop into almost like a Linkin Park hybrid EDM thing. So it all came from the drums. So, all right, so here's the live drums, cool. So this is like everything combined, like these are the drums. I thought this part came out so cool. But then all together with everything, you kind of get this like live feeling. Oh, in here, here's a little cool part. Just took her vocal. Chopped it up, messed around a little bit. Yeah, this rack's a little crazy. but very basic too at the same time. So then yeah, you have like that little moment there. All right, so let's see. Let's look at chat. How do I approach making that kind of sounds that insane? To be honest, it kind of evolves. Like, I think when you have a track and you kind of work on it and work on it and work on it, there's going to be things that get complicated, and then there's going to be things that stay the same. So like, it's funny, the first couple drafts of this record that me and Culture Code were sending back and forth, it was pretty much the same exact thing. Same exact thing. Like, not much changed except for the complications towards the end. So like, you basically, you have all this ear candy and you have all this extra stuff going on ultimately that you add at the end when you're trying to keep yourself interested and you want to have treats for people that are going to listen to it over and over and over again. Like, the goal with tracks, for me at least, is to have things, keep you interested on your fourth, fifth, sixth listen, where it's like, oh, I didn't hear that, or oh, I just discovered this thing. So I think that's kind of my pursuit of perfection, is to just have things there that keep you interested. Let's see. Appreciate you, Pretty Rokaya. Sorry. What's up, Breno? Do I have a first version of the song? I'm pretty sure I do. Let's see, spaces. Okay, I think this is it. Hold on. Let's see, I could probably pull this in Ableton. Oh, actually, this here. Go like this. Huh, that should work. I just gotta get out of full screen here. That's kind of what's messing me up. All right, we could drag this in here. Yeah, sorry, the audio routing is a little, the audio routing is like a little funky at the moment, just because I'm like streaming from here using this other service to kind of like allow me to hear it, you guys hear it at the same time. But so let's see. You and I, we feel these things the same. A little breath of wind can feel like a hurricane. Sometimes I turn my back. So this is the original demo right here. No, no, big guy, the drop is not different. I don't know why it's overdriving. That's weird. I don't know why that's overdriving. Yeah, I don't know why I was overdriving. That's crazy. Yeah, clip. No, no, no. There was no clipping. I don't know why. Oh, there's a saturator on it. Duh. All right. See, I wasn't crazy. I knew it was okay. There we go. I don't know why there was a saturator. Like, you see how much simpler that is? It's just so much simpler. Whereas now, yeah, no, it's hard to tell the difference. But it's like right now, here, we'll turn all this back on. So yeah, ultimately you're just adding things, you know, to keep it true to the original. But yeah, you're trying to preserve the idea, because that's why you're working on it. You know, that's why it's sometimes you can be your own worst enemy when it comes to creating music. That's the biggest thing. You can be your own worst enemy when you are working on a track, you love it, but then all of a sudden you say, hey, this could be better. That could be better. Oh, I heard this record from this person. Oh, I need the mix to be better. And next thing you know, you'll be working on a track for a year, changing this, changing that. And then you almost lose the essence of why you started that track in the first place. So it's crucial that at some point, like if a song is making you feel a certain way, you want to make sure that you stick with that original thing that made you happy, you know? Would I ever do track feedbacks on a stream? 100%. Absolutely. I would love to do a feedback stream. Yeah, I think we'll find a way. Like, listen, if you guys want to follow me on Instagram or TikTok or whatever, shoot me a follow and maybe a message, and then we'll try to figure out a way. Or actually, if you have a Twitter, that's probably the easiest, because sometimes like my notifications are off on Instagram. Hit me up on Twitter. And maybe we could try to like organize a cool little review stream. You know, we could do like a little half and half thing. So, all right, big guy, you sent some DMs. Yeah, sometimes it's weird. It's like people that I'm friends with on Instagram, or sometimes their messages, there's like all these different, there's these different folders where you have to get like a request. Like there's this whole request folder. But try me, Dreco, follow me on Instagram, and big guy, hit me up on Twitter. All right, so really quick, guys, let me just make sure we're still good here. Cool. All right, so I just want to show you one thing on how to stay creative. We'll show you a cool little sorry if I closed out the melodic aspect. Sorry, if I miss anything, I can always go back into it. I just want to show you this sweet little way to stay inspired, okay? So, we could do some basic little thing right here, okay? This is not like, I don't know what I'm about to do. I'm just going to try to show you like the resampling and ways of just kind of getting cool ideas. All right, so we will go... We will go here. By the way, shout out Spitfire Audio. Labs is legit. It's free. Go to Spitfire Audio, download Labs, and you will literally get a ton of amazing stuff for free. Like, literally free. By the way, I keep hitting my head into this thing, my hat. All right. So let's see. We'll go here. We'll just find something cool. Oh, there's my 808. Or maybe we can go to like one of these guys. Perfect. This is perfect. Why does that keep happening? Oh, because I got two selected. Duh. All right. Cool. So we'll set the tempo. We'll just say 165. Cool. And then we'll really quick, we'll start drawing some stuff in. Put our click on. Quick question. Did you ever hear? Wait, if not, you should listen. No, I will definitely check that out. Definitely, for sure. So I'm just going to do some quick thing. All right, cool. So like there's one little aspect, right? Like do 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 do. Okay. So we'll start to process this. All right, basic melody, like something simple. Ready? Ooh. Oh, now it's doing the record on both of them. Okay. Ooh. Ooh. Cool. Ooh. All right, there's that. So now what we could do is, of course, always the trusty auto-tune. So we'll throw this on D minor really quick. Ooh. Or is it D major? I'm not sure. Nope, D minor. Ooh. Ooh. Oh, wait. Yeah. Okay, we'll throw some effects on this. Ooh. By the way, this is like a little rack that I made. Okay, now let's get a little bass in here. Ooh. Sorry, now I'm like starting to work. This is what happens. Because you start chasing an idea. All right, let's throw a delay on this and then... Then we will take this. This has got to kind of be a little bit more... little crazier. All right. So there's like a basic idea right there. Okay. Like just a start of a track. So what I'll do is I will take this and I'll throw this thing, this cool feature, throwing this on resample. And then I'll literally just resample that back in. Okay. So I'll let it go too, because sometimes you'll get some cool stuff happening at the end. All right. Next thing. Sorry if I'm running through this quick, but so next thing I do is I will grab a sampler and I'll drag that in. And I think it might be simpler because Yes, it's got to be simpler. Sorry. Because this is like the difference is. All right, so now all of a sudden you hear it. Like now we just dropped all that stuff in. now we kind of have like our own little sample, right? Right? So then what I like to do, so then you could obviously play it and add some like Timbo drums to it. You know? But that's a lot of fun. But what's really cool about Simpler is you can map the start, right? So we are gonna map the start here. You could also map the length. Oh, unmap that. All right. So we're going to map the length over here. Okay. So now check it out. So we'll just start. Oh, I got to do the, I got to map the start one more time. Okay. So here you go. You could now then in Ableton, you could take an arpeggiator, right? Let's do this. We'll just like draw out, see what note sounds the best. Okay. All right. So here we have this going, right? So then you can start going like boom, digga 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 boo, boo, digga 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 digga, like this. So like, so then here we have like, we can go fully ungated. And then we could turn this on. Oh, gotta copy the automation. So then it's like all of a sudden now. And then now you have this little groove thing, you know, all from just resampling a song that we just did. I mean, that part sounds like crap, but yeah, that's a basic idea. And then you could start adding your little, could start adding your Jersey club kicks. I'm just joking around. So, but you see what happens. So it's like it all, that little thing, that little idea came from this. Actually, I could group these together. Group these together real quick. So here you go. Like you got this. So now this. You know, super simple. But all right. I think this was a productive little first stream. Greco, I'ma probably be hopping off in a sec. But I appreciate you being on here. Did I ever use all right, big guy, got you. Okay. So this was a while back. Here we go. I actually did. Download it? See. There we go. All right. So this, no one's ever heard this one. So I actually sampled my son when he was much younger. I sampled his vocals. So here you go. So this is actually my son. This whole song came from it, and then I turned it into a song for live. This is all intro stuff here, and then my buddy Nick recorded on it. Shake that, wiggle that, make your back work. Make a jump, girl, slap it off the backboard. Don't front, let me see you with your back turn. Poke it out, make it bounce, move backwards. Don't stop, girl, do it how I asked for. All access, like I got the password. Give me hook, make your boy come back for it. Work that till you got me talking backwards. So this is the part that's my son. That's him at like 2 years old. Just madness. Yeah. So to answer your question, I definitely use my kid's voice. Yeah, my son is actually 9. All right. Appreciate it. All right. Well, guys, listen. I am going to run. I appreciate you all for being here today. So follow me on Twitter, follow me on Instagram. We can get a weekly thing. We could get it 2 times a week. Also, let me know what you guys want to see. You know, I'm also thinking of possibly doing some like live mixes and stuff like that. Really whatever. Just communicate to me and let me know what you guys are feeling, because this could be a lot of fun. Like, obviously, we're still working the whole thing out, and we can make this a fun weekly thing. One final question. Shall I send the Discord here and make it an official Discord? Adrew Discord. Big guy, hit me up with it. Cause I already have like a Discord. So I just want to see, cause I already have Adrew Music Discord. So I just got to see how I got to do it, but shoot it to me. But I will let you know to see what goes on. Like, as far as like, if that's the one, or if the one that I currently have is the one, I just don't know really how to use Discord at the moment, but I appreciate you for getting that. George, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Big guy, if you could hit me up on Twitter, that'd be much easier. All right, guys. Well, listen, thank you so much. Make sure you follow. I could do this. Should have done that. All right. Guys, thank you. Appreciate you. I will maybe do this sooner, or maybe, you know what? Definitely next week I will do this on a Wednesday at 5 p.m. So stay tuned and make sure you hit me up. Let me know what you want, and we'll make it happen. Appreciate you guys. Thank you. Bye.